What's going on, guys? AliRx here, and this is my first impressions of the demo that just came out on the eShop for Super Smash Bros. For the Nintendo 3DS. I am very excited for this game, and I know a lot of other people are. Everyone is really, really hyped for Smash Bros. 3DS, as well as Smash Bros. For Wii U, which doesn't come out until December. Or what, November, December? God knows when. But it's sometime around the end of this year. And the 3DS version comes out next month, early October. But the demo of Smash Bros. For 3DS is already out. And what do I think of it? Well, it's no surprise. Smash Bros. 3DS is looking awesome so far. The demo is fantastic, and I loved it, and it was a whole lot of fun. So anyway, let me get into detail why the Smash Bros. For 3DS is very impressive, and I am very impressed with the game, the demo, even though it's just a demo. First thing I want to say, I was very skeptical about this particular version of Smash Brothers, not only due to the Wii U version, which is superior, most likely going to be superior, but also that the fact that the new 3DS was just announced and that Smash Brothers was going to have extra features and it was going to play better and run better on the new 3DS, it left me very skeptical about playing Smash Brothers on the original 3DS, which I have. Like, it wasn't going to be good frame rate. The controls were going to be stripped down, and it just wasn't going to be that fun, and stuff like that. But I got my hands on it, I played it for a while, and I'll be honest, I was very surprised. The frame rate is very smooth. I think it runs at a decent 60-ish frames per second, maybe not so much, but it's smooth enough. It's smooth like the other Smash Brothers games. Even with four characters on the screen, I'm very impressed with the game so far. You don't see it here because the webcam quality, and I apologize for that. You know, webcam quality is not so great, but if you actually play the game on the 3DS, if you just download from the eShop, then you will see why, what I mean. The overall, the frame rate is impressive, and even the graphics are very good. You know, they don't look too pixelated and stuff. They're very well done. You know, that's impressive for a portable Smash Brothers game, especially compared to the Wii U. And if it can look and play this good on the original 3DS, just imagine how well it would play on the new 3DS. Now, as for the controls, controls are very well done. Controls are excellent. You know, they're easy to get into. The buttons are easy to recognize. You know, you got B to do like the special attacks, like the fire flower, the sword attack, the Pikachu's Thunderball, Mega Man's Mega Buster, whatnot, and you got A button to do like the melee attacks and whatnot, you know, and stuff like that. And then you have a bunch of other attacks like Y and X and other stuff. But if you pick it up, the controls are very familiar. If you played Brawl with the classic controller, you should be very familiar with Smash Bros. 3DS. So yeah, it's incredibly fun, easy to get into. Now the ultimate question everyone wants to know: is it faster than Brawl? Is it slower than Melee? Is it as fast as Melee? Is it as slow as Brawl? How is the speed overall? Well, the speed is great. It's the right speed. It's not as fast as Melee. It's faster than Brawl. Well, not that much faster than Brawl, but it's at an enjoyable pace. It's not sluggish. It's not too slippery. It's incredibly fun. You gotta remember, although I enjoy Melee over Brawl because of how fast it was, sometimes Melee was a bit slippery. You know, I've recently looked back at both Melee and Brawl, you know, because of a upcoming video that I'm working on. But to be honest, although I loved Melee more than Brawl, the game can be slippery sometimes. I'm not gonna lie to you. But overall, Smash Bros. For 3DS is at the right speed. It's at the right speed, and it's enjoyable enough for anyone to play. Now, there are 5 playable characters in the demo: Mario, Link, Pikachu, Mega Man, and the villager from Animal Crossing. You know, I didn't play as the villager much, since I'm not a huge fan of Animal Crossing, since I really don't care all that much for the villager. But, you know, one thing that's interesting about the villager is that how you change the costumes. And, like, you can change to completely different people, including this weird-looking girl. Yeah. And, for the most part, I played as Mega Man. And I really enjoyed playing as Mega Man. He does the Mega Buster. He does the charge up attacks. He shoots the Metal Blade, and he does a tornado attack. I forgot who does the tornado attack. It was from. Who does the tornado attack? My memory's kind of fuzzy here. It's from like. From one of the 4, 5, and 6 Mega Man games. I don't think it's from 1, 2, or 3. So I've played 1 and 2 the most. I once in a while go to 3, but I very rarely play Mega Man 4, 5, and 6. So I'm not too familiar with where the tornado attack is from. Maybe it's from Mega Man 9. Maybe it's from Mega Man 9 or 10. But fuck, I do not remember. So yeah, he does the Mega Buster. He does like this attack where he just smashes you from when you're coming down, from when you're above and you're coming down, and Mega Man would just do this attack where you hold up and press like the melee attack, and then bam, and it would just destroy you, and knock you out of the arena. There he's got a lot of really awesome attacks. One minor complaint I have is that he doesn't have many punches and kicks. His standard shooting attacks with the Mega Buster aren't very strong. In fact, you know, if he had punches and kicks, I'd say they would probably be much stronger than using the regular, you know, Mega Buster attacks. Now, I'm not talking about the charge up or any of the special attacks. I'm talking about the standard Mega Buster attack. You know, like pew pew pew, one with the yellow peach ball that comes out. The standard Mega Buster attack. You know, it's not very strong. It doesn't really do much damage. And that's the only minor complaint I have. But overall, his attacks are very impressive. And let me tell you, his final smash, and you can see it right here in the video, his final smash is so badass. The way his final smash works is that he would use like Galaxy Man's attack, where it would create a tornado that sucks your opponent in, and as soon as your opponent goes in the tornado, all the other versions of Mega Man, like Mega Man X, Battle Network Mega Man, Star Force Mega Man, Zero, and whatever, all the other versions of Mega Man, Legends, they all come together and they do this big Mega Buster attack, and it's just fucking awesome. I'm sorry. Sorry if I said that, but his Mega Buster is just so badass. I just love it. But overall, Mega Man is fan-fucking-tastic. I love playing as Mega Man. The other characters like Mario, Link, and Pikachu, they're more or less the same as they were in Brawl and even Melee. Their final smashes are the same, pretty much. So yeah, they're pretty much exactly the same as they were in Brawl. Mario, Link, and Pichu, although they play faster because the game itself is faster. A bit faster, I mean. One thing I noticed about the game specifically Link, is that when Link does the dash attack, he would jump. Like in a Melee Brawl in the N64 game, like when he would run and attack, he would just run and he would slash. But in this game, he would run and then jump and then attack with his sword. I don't know. I just found that weird to me. I honestly prefer the old way where he just run and slash you. Not run, jump, and then slash you with the sword. Now, I'm not too keen about that. You know. But overall, Link plays the same, and Mario hasn't changed at all, pretty much. Pikachu hasn't changed at all either. And that's all I have to say about the playable characters in the game. Presentation wise, I think it's amazing. It's very clean. It's on par with Brawl's presentation, but more colorful and more dynamic. I do love the way the menus look. You know, the all the features they have, and it, even though you can't get to play as all the features, the features they've shown so far, like Wii U connectivity, Street Pass, there's so many other features I can't think of right now at the top of my head. I'm very impressed. I cannot wait to play the full version of the game. I cannot wait. I'm really excited to play it. And judging by the number of characters they have, even though they're not all playable, I am very impressed with the roster so far. It's got all the returning characters: Yoshi, Bowser, Luigi, Peach, Kirby, Samus, Captain Falcon, and it even has new characters like the Little Mac, Pac-Man, and one of the Xenoblade characters, Chronicles. And it also has Fire Emblem characters. And I am very impressed with the roster so far. And one thing I will say is I wish they had more third-party characters, you know. Although it's only one more character than what Brawl had. Brawl had only two third-party characters. This time, there's only three. Sonic, Mega Man, and Pac-Man. I do wish they had more, though. Maybe this is a pattern. Maybe Brawl had two. For 3DS and for Wii U, we'll have three. Maybe the fifth installment will have four. I hope not, though. I hope this is not a trend where they have, like, one extra third-party character per game. Now, I do have one complaint about the demo specifically. Only time is available. That's the only option to play in the versus mode. Now that's one thing I do not like to play in any of the Smash Brothers games. I like playing stock or coin or anything else, but time is just weird to me. Like, I don't know. Like, there's, for me, it gets confusing, especially when there's like four characters on the screen and there's a timer going on. When people die and a bunch of other characters die, including myself, it's hard to tell who is winning and who's losing. Like, the winner and loser always seem random to me at time. I know that the one who dies the most is like the winner, but from what I see during like when it's four players against each other in a time match, and then they die a bunch of times, they all die a bunch of times, it can get a bit confusing. I much prefer stock, because I can see how many lives they have left. And yeah, it's better for me. Just my opinion. So all in all, the Smash Brothers 3DS demo was great. It's incredibly fun. It delivers like any other Smash Brothers game. You can't go wrong with Smash Brothers, although Brawl wasn't that great. The online could have been better, and the Subspace Emissary wasn't that great compared to Adventure Mode, in my opinion. But overall, you can't go wrong with Smash Brothers, and Smash Brothers for 3DS is no exception. Now, will I buy it at launch? Probably not, because of New York Comic Con. I gotta spend money on stuff when I'm there. And it's a shame, really, because, you know, I would love to street pass everybody at New York Comic Con with Smash Brothers. And, you know, just kind of versus everybody. You know, and it just sucks that I probably won't get to play and street pass everyone in Smash Brothers at New York Comic Con. What a damn shame for me. But other than that, I'm definitely looking forward to playing it. I'm definitely gonna pick it up very soon, but not too soon. I will definitely pick it up, and I will also pick up the Wii U version when I get it this Christmas. That's exactly what I've been waiting for. That's the only game that's gonna entice me to buy a Wii U at the moment. I mean, don't get me wrong, there are other great games like Mario Kart 8, Hyrule Warriors, Super Mario 3D World, and a few others that are coming out next year. But there's really not a whole lot. But the only really, really must-have game for me is Smash Brothers for Wii U. That's the game that's gonna entice me to buy a Wii U this holiday. And I'm glad it's coming out this holiday. I hope it doesn't get delayed. If not, I'm gonna cancel getting a Wii U this Christmas. Cause if it gets delayed, I'm gonna be very disappointed. But then again, maybe getting delayed will probably help polish the game. But at the same time, it would be a very disappointing holiday for Wii U. You know, of course, there's Bayonetta 2 coming out. Hyrule Warriors is coming out. But other than that, there's not a whole lot. Mario Kart 8 came out earlier this year. So yeah, there's a big drought in Wii U games for 2014. But I hope Smash Brothers... That's why I'm hoping Smash Brothers comes out this year in the holiday season. So anyway, that's it for my Smash Brothers 3DS impressions. Stay tuned for the next episode of the AliRx Show, which is DuckTales Remastered. And after that is another Smash Brothers video on the AliRx Show. One that is very, very special. It's not a review of a specific Smash Brothers game. It's going to be very different from what I've done before. It's actually the first of a comparison video where I compare two of the best games. In this one, I'm going to compare Melee and Brawl in this particular episode of the AliRx Show after I review DuckTales Remastered. So be sure to check out that. So until next time, I'm AliRx, and I'll see you on the other side.